Welcome back to Homebrew Audio for another tutorial on audio recording and production. Today, we'll introduce the concept of equalization, or EQ, and frequency, bass, treble, high, low, etc., so we can start expanding the wild and woolly world of effects, or FX, as the cool kids call it. Effects are used to change the sound of the audio in some way, either to fix or improve it, or for artistic effect. We've already touched on a couple such tools when we showed you in earlier tutorials how to reduce noise, trim, and time shift audio. Back then, I called them editing tools. Well, editing tools make up a subset of effects. But we're here to talk about frequency. It's such a technical sounding word, isn't it? And this topic can be complicated. But really, the basics are pretty simple. It's all in how you explain it. So here we go. All audio is created by vibrating air molecules. When something makes a noise, it's because it caused air molecules to vibrate back and forth. And that vibration moves through the air until it reaches your ear. Certain types of audio vibrate back and forth really fast. These are the high or treble sounds. Deep or bass-sounding audio causes air to vibrate back and forth much more slowly. Another way of saying this is that the trebly audio vibrates more often or more frequently in 1 second than the bass or low-sounding audio, whose vibrations happen fewer times per second or less frequently. So we say that sound vibrating more frequently has a high frequency, and sound vibrating less frequently has a low frequency. Here's an example of the lowest frequency, one vibration up and down, or one cycle in 1 second. Here's one with a slightly higher frequency of four vibrations in 1 second. And this is a picture of 6 cycles per second. See? Not so hard. The other thing you need to know about is that there is a nickname given to how frequently, or how often, the vibrations happen in 1 second. And that nickname is Hertz, named after a guy called Heinrich Rudolf Hertz. All Hertz means is cycles per second. One Hertz, usually abbreviated HZ, is one vibration back and forth, or one cycle per second. All three of those examples, though, that we just looked at, are frequencies that humans can't hear. Humans can only hear audio that vibrates in the range of 20 Hertz to 20,000 Hertz. Air molecules have to vibrate at least 20 times per second before humans can hear it. And we can't hear anything over 20,000 or 20 kilohertz. So now we can apply those terms like low and deep and high and trebly to actual numbers. Typically, we consider the low or bass frequencies to be at 250 hertz or below, and the high frequencies to be 5,000 Hertz, abbreviated as 5 kilohertz, or just 5 kHz, and above. And then there's the stuff in between. We might just say everything between high and low make up the middle frequencies, but then even that is often broken into low mids, mids, and high mids, which usually correspond to 250 to 500 Hertz for the low mids, 500 to 3 kilohertz as the mids, and 3 to 6 kHz as the high mids. These are all pretty subjective, though. Different people will give you different answers as to what to call these bands of frequencies. And all these frequencies can be broken up into just about as many different bands as you want. So, what is equalization? Well, here's another example of a term whose name is not very descriptive. I mean, equalizer? What's being made equal? And what is it being made equal to? Can be confusing. So here is what it actually does. Equalization is basically a volume control, but a normal volume control turns all the frequencies up or down. Lows, highs, mids, everything. Whereas an EQ lets you decide which frequencies to turn up or down. One example of an EQ that you may not realize you're already familiar with is the control on most car stereos that usually says bass and treble. That kind of EQ only divides the frequencies into two bands. You can turn just the low frequencies up or down, which in this case is a much larger bunch of frequencies than we had talked about earlier, pretty much all the stuff on the left, or just the high frequencies up or down, and that would be pretty much all the stuff on the right. But if you turn both the treble and the bass knobs all the way up, all you've really done is the same thing as if you'd turn the volume knob up, because you push the volume of all the frequencies up or down. Most EQ effect tools and recording software have more knobs or sliders than just bass and treble. This allows us more choices on which frequencies of the sound to play with to give us the best result. Let's look at the EQ tool in Audacity. First, let's open the file we've been working with in Audacity, called Slow Rock Drum Basic 104 BPM for beats per minute, October 2014. If you don't already have this on your hard drive, you can download it from the Homebrew Audio website. I showed you how to do that in the last lesson. So once you've got your file open, select some of the audio, either by dragging on it here, just to select some, or you can select it all by coming to some blank space over in the track control panel and double-clicking, like so. Then go to the Effect drop-down menu and pick Equalization. What a surprise. Now here is that spectrum that I mentioned before of frequencies. The lowest frequency is on the left. That's the lowest frequency that humans can hear at 20 Hertz, 20 cycles per second. And at the high end is 20,000 Hertz, sometimes written as 20 kilohertz, which is the high end of humans' ability to hear sound. Now notice the blue line in the middle here. That's at 0 dB, which means 0 decibels. And that's telling you that none of the frequencies have been turned up or down. Remember, the low frequencies are over here on the left, and the high frequencies are over here on the right. So the first thing we need to do is listen to the audio without any EQ applied. So just click Preview. So there's with no EQ. Now come up here to about the middle somewhere and just click on the line. That'll put a little point there, and that acts like a little hinge or like an elbow. So come all the way to the left end of the line, click on that, hold it down, and drag that all the way up to the top. Then come over to the right all the way to the end, click on that and drag that all the way to the bottom so it goes right into the corner. And let's take a listen to what we've got. Notice how you hear mostly boomy, sort of muddy sound and not a lot of high, crystal, tinkly sound? That's because we increased the bass and decreased the treble, the highs. Let's listen to it flat again. Hit flatten. Okay, now let's do the opposite. Start by putting a dot in the middle again. Now let's raise the treble and lower the bass. So raise the right side all the way to the top into the corner and lower the bass into the left-hand corner there. And listen to what we've got. Now that had like no bass or boomy sound at all and all trebly sound, all high frequencies instead. So let's preview it flat again. So those were some pretty extreme examples. Let's check out some of the preset curves here, or preset programs for EQ that they have. One here they call AM radio, or the telephone. You know how things sound real thin on the telephone? Here's what that curve would look like. It filters out all of this stuff over here and here and just leaves these middle frequencies and sounds like this. Flatten. If you ever wanted to just give it a fairly gentle boost in just the bass, there's your bass boost. And if you just wanted to give it a little bit of a treble boost, you could use that one. Now we've been using the draw curves view here, and that allows you to put these little lines in here and you can basically move them around how you want to. But until you really know what you're doing, one of the best tools to use, certainly the easiest, is the graphic EQ, which has 31 distinct bands of frequencies already set for you. So we've got 20 Hertz at the bottom, 20,000 Hertz at the top, and as you hover over these sliders, you can see the center frequency for the bands that are being controlled here. And what I mean by center frequency, let's take, say, the 80 hertz band right here, and I'll slide that up, and you'll see the effect that that has. That increases the volume at the frequency of 80 hertz by 12 decibels. But it also increases some of these frequencies to the left and to the right of 80 hertz, and the entire collection of frequencies that gets boosted or decreased is called a band of frequencies or a group. So why learn about this stuff? Well, for now, it's going to be helpful to know that we can turn certain frequencies down or up without affecting the rest of the audio. And we'll use that knowledge in the next lesson when we use EQ to fix a common problem we often run into when recording voices. So, now you know what frequency means, and what EQ is, and what it does. I'll see you back here for lesson 8, where we'll put that knowledge to work. See you then!